I was working with somebody today and came across something that I figured I just had to stop and show you. This isn't something that's directly Excel. This is about whooping crap data, uncovering crap data. We don't talk about that enough. We talk about tips and tricks, but this was fascinating the way that this thing unfolded. This real project had a whole lot of data, lots of spreadsheets that needed to be pulled apart and put back together again in other ways, parsed and mashed and rolled around, and then we eventually get to where we want to do our analysis. Here we've got courses, days, weeks, locations, problems. Stephanie taught CR04 on the second week, Thursday, at the 8th Avenue location, and there was a facility problem. Now we go over here because we want to examine problems, level of problems. Got a few pivot tables built. We can see 8th Avenue had the most problems with 6th and Mall just right behind it, and Anchor Park Clubhouse just with 3 problems. We can see that Channing is at least reporting the most problems. I'm working with this person, and then he observes, wait a minute. There's a lot of stuff in the problems column that looks like write-ins and weird stuff that we don't care about at our level. And look at the first two rows. Arnold, Tuesday, CR04, week 2, Anchor Park Clubhouse, facility, and a note about a skunk. Ah, so we realized people were making additional rows to make amplifying notes. So this note about a skunk is really amplifying the facility problem. We only care about the facility problem, but we had done all this analysis over here. That's really what I want to show you because I see this so much, and we got to spread the word about being able to look at our data and investigate the quality of it before we start building models and complex formulas and queries and making anti-joins and stuff. So spread that word. The person that I was working with, he pointed out the problems that we need to pay attention to. Audiovisual down to supplies. Those are the only ones. Anything else are those amplifying notes. Breakfast never showed up. That amplifies a food and catering problem. How are we going to dig this stuff out? Here we go, and I'm going to do this real quick. Troubles. From table slash range, the table does have headers. Okay. List, then woes. I want to do an inner join. Inner, only matching rows. Match up troubles with problems. Okay. We don't want this woes column. Right click, remove. Now we just have Arnold, Tuesday, Anchor Park Clubhouse, and no more note about a skunk. Here we go. Close and load. Now let's do a simple pivot table to look at the venues and the number of problems. Insert. Pivot table. And I'm going to sit it right here on this page. Okay. Close this. Location. Problems. The overall order of things has not changed much, but we can see now 6th and Mall has 6 fewer problems than we thought originally. Also, because we cleaned up that one column, we can do more with the pivot table and have it mean something and not be all cluttered up. I'm going to move this pivot table. And then I'm going to add in the problem here. And then let's sort. Most of 8th Avenue's problems are around food and catering. And we see Anchor Park Clubhouse had one supplies problem, one facility problem, and somebody else can deal with that damn skunk. Please, share the word with people about their data quality. The stuff that we had to do here in Excel was not hard. The hard part was just identifying the crap data, understanding the business and the data enough to recognize it. Once this guy does the analysis with this data and sends it to his boss, he won't have to go apologize later about not finding that damn skunk. See you in the next video.